Well, I am Lauren, and I am sitting here with Lauren Knott on the set, which is actually very exciting. I don't usually get to sit on the set of NRAC's Spring Awakening, and you play Ilsa.
Yes, ma'am.
But I wanted to talk to you as part of kind of my one to watch installment, because I really, there was something about your performance. Your performance is lovely and compelling, and you have this beautiful voice.
Thank you so much.
You just kind of stood out to us. My husband too. So I was like, okay, I want to talk to her.
So well, thank you.
So how long have you been performing, and when did you first kind of get bitten by the acting bug?
Sure. I have always been a singer. I'm a singer first and foremost. My mom likes to tell a story of when I was about six, I gave a very jazzy rendition of Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. She said that's when I knew that you were probably gonna do the singing thing. I started doing theater when I was probably 12. I did some community work with Carrie Youth Applause Theater. They were lovely. And then in high school, I started working at NRAC, I started working at RLT. And so I've really just been, it's been the great passion of my life ever since.
Kind of once you get bitten. My daughter said, don't say acting bug. That sounds silly.
But,
you know,
it doesn't sound silly.
So did you go to school? In high school, obviously you did theater, but did you, after high school, did you study acting?
I spent a year at Meredith studying acting and classical voice. And then I decided that I didn't necessarily have the temperament to do this professionally. So I'm actually at State in the Psychology and Communications programs.
Oh, nice. And do you have a favorite role, favorite show that you've done?
I do have a favorite role. Okay. I did a play called Perfect Arrangement at Raleigh Little Theater last year by Topher Payne, where I played a 1950s lesbian housewife. And it is just far and above the greatest role I've ever played. I'm a queer woman myself, so like getting to play a queer woman on stage was very exciting and very new and very wonderful. And it was such a heavy, important story that it was just a joy to be a part of it.
And I cannot not talk about Spring Awakening because we're here at North Raleigh Arts Creative Theater. It's a beautiful set. You play Ilsa. Mm-hmm. You have two gorgeous duets, the Dark I Know Well,
yes,
and Blue Wind, Don't Do Sadness. Mm-hmm. And then you have some solos. You have solo in Purple Summer. Mm-hmm. How is it playing Ilsa and stepping into such an intense role? What's this experience been like?
Yeah, Ilsa, she was difficult for me to find because she is a very complex character, and she's a lot darker than I think a lot of people give her credit for. Because her story is she was abused by her father, she runs away and joins an artist colony, and you don't see any of her life in the artist colony except for that little monologue where she talks about getting drunk and being chased by a man. But from that, the life I constructed for her is very sad, because she's out there having to survive the only way she knows how, by using her body to like keep her life going. And so I think I might be a little darker than people are used to in this role, but the music is gorgeous. My scene partners are all wonderful. Tim is a wonderful director. It's just been a dream, really.
And the response has been good.
The response, yes.
They were telling me it's almost sold out, so you gotta get tickets. It runs through June 17th.
Hurry.
But the response has been very good. And I think the passion you all have for this material and that Tim has for the material,
yes,
really comes through on stage.
Yeah, we've had a lot of people come up after the show and tell us that they've been very touched, that the material is so close to so many people's hearts and experiences that it can be very cathartic for people to experience this show with us. And I'm very blessed to have the audiences we do, have the director, the cast we do. I'm glad that people are enjoying it and seeing something of themselves that they can take away.
And you talked a little bit about your interpretation of Ilsa, and I spoke to Tim before the show opened about Spring Awakening, but for people who don't know, you know, obviously it's Tony Sunday. Spring Awakening,
yes,
won a bunch of Tony Awards. but what is Spring Awakening about?
Oh, gosh. It's hard to give a 12-second elevator pitch. Spring Awakening is about these young teenagers in Germany in 1891, sort of discovering their sexuality, discovering, trying to figure out their identities, trying to live in this world where they're always sort of pushed down by society and by their parents and not told how the world is, and just trying to figure everything out. And some of them do it okay, and some of them really struggle. So.
In a nutshell.
In a nutshell.
And beautiful music, beautiful
score. Beautiful music.
What's next for you? What's after Spring Awakening?
I do not have anything planned right now. I'm going out of the country for a little bit in July, and so I've had to push off auditioning for things because can't miss 2 weeks of rehearsal.
No.
So I'm not sure. We'll see.
And kind of what's the dream? You know, you said, I don't believe this, that you said you don't have the temperament for performing or for going into this professionally, but what are some of your long-term goals? Do you kind of hope to continue performing on community stages, regional stages, mm-hmm. or are you going to go into broadcast like I did?
Well, I mean, in an ideal world, of course, I would love to do theater professionally. But I think sort of right now, I'm going to school for psychology, as I said. My hope is to become a therapist, a counseling therapist, and just continue doing what I love, you know, on the side. People call it a hobby, but I feel like that feels diminutive. I call it a passion, which sounds a little pretentious. But, you know, it's the great joy of my life is getting to sing, getting to perform for people, and I'm happy to do that any way I'm able, regardless of whether I'm being paid or not.
Do you have I guess I should ask this too. Do you have a favorite, we talked about a favorite role, but do you have a favorite song in Spring Awakening that you just...
In Spring Awakening? Mm-hmm. My duet with Nathan, Blue Wind, Don't Do Sadness.
It's gorgeous.
And I love Nathan. I've known him for a year or two, and getting to perform with him has been so wonderful. And that song is so visceral, and so there's so much longing and confusion and hurt, and I just love it. It's real good.
And it comes at such a pivotal, critical part in the
yes.
show that I think it's really intense. The way you guys portray it is
Thank
very
you.
Intense.
Thank you.
But anyway, go see it. Spring Awakening runs through June 17th here at Interact. You can get tickets online. Mm-hmm. The online ticketing system is working up and
yes.
running.
Yes.
And we hope to see you again on stage soon.
Great. Thank you so much, Lauren.
Thank you.